to the home.
Alfie, this is probably the longest you've been out of here. You're starting to feel the heat on the beach.
Yeah, I'm getting
there somewhere.
One more, that's all we need.
That's it, just one more. Look, it seems to be paying off all this crap. We're going to do a screamer over the head, you're going to catch that next time, aren't you?
That's so sad,
Scott.
Last time we're back in the Bronx. Timeout's been called here on base runner. We've got to be able to put another base runner on. Oh, okay. All right, fair enough. Never argue with the umpire, Stokes. Broncos have got two base runners. Haley, how do you feel about that? No worries. Wally Lewis, the king! Oh, this pitch. Haley Pitch is there. She's got the ball. I wonder whether she would tag him or she couldn't tag. Probably just tag him. Ruby Alley goes into the right field. Will this be two runs for the Broncos? Throw on its way. Oh, the left-hand game. Holly's taking the bat with him in case he needed it.
Now, Holly, you've scored the tie runs. What was going on in your head? What's happened?
A complete accident. It'll never happen again.
Completely blank. Seems you function well at all. I can't amplify that either. No pressure, but time runs on two, I believe that.
Incorrect.
The Broncos I've been correct again. I want a roll.
The Broncos actually had the score wrong. I was told the Broncos score is 8-7. Broncos now. And there's an easy out, so to speak. Wally Lewis doesn't want to commit himself too much off the bases. He just sort of hung there and waited. Maybe he's looking for a pinch runner.
Albie's getting a bit of abuse from Wally, but he's calling him soft. Harsh.
Probably true.
It might be true.
Yeah,
consider that.
Well, now the hitter, ladies and gentlemen, facing Haley Pitch and trying a few trick shots. Ooh, high and soft. Watch out. Pearl. Right off the change-up.
Now see, he's only hit the ball on the infield line, which means you're going to have to run.
I hope that the audience are patient.
Now that can't scare you too much, that type of pitching.
That's So Steve Randolph gets into first base, Molly Lewis at second. The Broncos lead by 1 run, 8-7. And who's this? Towers.
Rory
Watts
there,
darling.
Pretty
nice
pitch.
1-2. Give him another chance, eh? Because he's the patron.
Preferential treatment?
Yeah. 2.5 strokes.
Well, he's pretty excited here. He's pretty keen to be running home.
There we go.
It doesn't look too
Wally's tagged out.
Steve, I don't think Wally was with your program there. Was the plan for Wally to score and you to end up on the tree?
I can't believe I was telling the king to run.
Oh, look out. Base hit, goes in the left. Run comes in, the Steve Randolph. And he scores 9-7. And Tony Carroll comes out of the dugout. Thank you.
Now, what about me? Might be getting a bit of your own back there. How does it feel?
It feels good.
Are you going to rush the plane?
The score, Broncos. Stacey Porter, right inside, doesn't like that. Two young scampers to second base. Brooke Morgan's the other runner. An opportunity here with Nana. 3-1 the count. And she gets walked. Base is loaded now. Here we go, in Vogler. Is going to win two in a row.
90% of games are lost in the last innings, Alfie, do you know that?
What's that, right?
Roll with the punches.
Swings, misses. One ball, two strikes. Pump it up.
Good thing is, though, that 75% of statistics are made up on the spot.
At home, they get it. The force play out at home. One down. Bases loaded. Hayley Petrie. Lines it down third base. Look out. Please be careful. Sure you're attentive, you are on the diamond. Not playing, please be careful. What's she done doing the pitching? Doing a good job. Rule comes high, inside.
Yeah, it's
10-0. 44 Australian caps at bat. Look out, got the talent. Had the practice. And ball, Colton Tallis gets that one and gets it. It's tied up. Tied up at 2-0.
And going into the card
race. I think he must have listened to his fellow players before he gave him a hard time. He's lifted his game, though.
I think that might be it, guys. It is.
Thanks, Dave. It's called Yellow the Pippin. Now, Dave, I don't know if I'm sure you do know, but I know everybody in the crowd knows that Melanie Roach is actually a bit of a singer-songwriter.